Yo, what's going on, Shiny Hunters? It's the Shiny Oreo coming back at you again with another YouTube video. And I do want to apologize, first of all. The animated figure that I've been doing, I've been putting on hold as of late just due to the fact that I have not been feeling good at all. I still feel like crap, by the way. But the show must go on. So I'm going to show you guys today how you guys can access PK Hex for your Nintendo Switch. Now, do note, you have to have a CFW switch to do this. If you guys enjoyed the content, make sure you guys definitely hit that like button. It helps me out a ton. Also, subscribe to the channel because I am on the road to 1K subs by the end of the year. And it would greatly help me out so much if you guys could do that. Without further ado, I'm going to be done wasting you guys' time. Let's get right into the video to show you guys how to get this done. So the first thing, obviously, you need is PK Hex. I will leave a link in the description down below for you guys, or you guys can just, you know, copy the URL up here. It doesn't matter. But once you get here, all you got to do is download the file. I already have the file downloaded, so I'm not going to re-download the file. But download the file, and it's going to put it right onto your PC, unzip it, and you're good to go. And we'll move on from there. All right, once you have the file downloaded and unzipped and all that, it's going to look just like this. If you've done PK Hex in a patch, you already know how this works. Once it looks like this, all you do is double-click it, and it's going to pop up right on your screen just like so. And this is PK Hex in a nutshell. Now, there's a lot you could do on this app. You can modify your save data. You can do all of that. Like I said before, though, you do need a CFW switch. So please keep that in mind if you don't have a CFW switch. There was a way towards the end of Sword and Shield where you can modify the save, like Pokemon. Not so much the save file, but the Pokemon without a CFW switch. But I've never dealt with any of that. In the future, I may try to cover it if it shows enough interest and if I can learn how to do it myself, because I do have a non-modified switch. But the program's going to look like this. You'll be able to modify any Pokemon and all that. I will show you guys how to do all that in a little bit. But first, I'm going to show you how to get your save file onto PKX. All right, once you have your Nintendo Switch in CFW mode, all you pretty much are going to have to do is go to the game, or I guess you could click on any game, and you're going to hold the R button, and then you're going to hit A. When you hit A, keep a hold of your R button. Do not let it go. Go into your profile, and it is obviously going to check. I file share, so. All right, once you're in this screen, just go to checkpoint, go to the game you want to modify. I'm actually going to delete this save file, and I'm going to create a new backup. So in order to create a new backup, hit the L button, and it's going to say backup selected save. You're going to hit yes. From here, you can name the file whatever you want. Just for the purpose of the video, I'll just name it test. All right. And then it says progress correctly saved to disk. Once that is done, you're pretty much done with this part. You can close out of the game and you can take your SD card and put it onto your PC. Once I do that, I will get right back with you and show you guys how to pull it up onto PK Hex. All right, once you have your safe, your SD card into your PC now, you'll notice here that your SD card, you'll have your, just like when you CFW'd your Switch, your folder's obviously going to look like this. You want to go into your Switch file, and then checkpoint, and then saves, and then find the Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl, whichever one. For Shining Pearl, it's going to be the one that ends in D92000. So you just double clicked it, and notice test is right here and my save bin is right there. So just to let you guys know that we do have the save file here. Once you know it is there and it is good to go, open up PK Hex. go into file, go to open, go into your SD card at this point, switch, checkpoint, saves, your game, and then your save data, you're gonna hit open, and your save file for your game is right here. At this point, you can pretty much modify the Pokemon however you want. You can do pretty much whatever the heck you want with this. This is updated to Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. The check is a little whack. So, like, the Pokemon you made could be 100% legal and for some reason still not run through their passive check for some reason. They do need to update the system, so do keep that in mind. It is not, like, fully updated yet. But as you can see, if you right-click on a Pokemon, like the Zubat, for instance, and you go to View, it'll pop right up. It's going to show you the name, the nickname, the experience, the level it is, what nature it is, and all that good stuff. The ability that it has, so I can give it its hidden ability if I want to. It's going to show you where you personally met it. It's going to show you the stats, so like I can change this... Zubat right here, I can pretty much make it 6 IV if I want to by changing all this to 31. Boop. 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 And then I can modify its EVs as well if I want to. So, just for giggles, we will do that. We'll change this all to 0 real fast. And then I'll give it 252 attack. And 252 speed, just to do it, right? And then we'll throw the other 4 and, I don't know, defense, just because. And that will bring it up to a 4-star rating, which is freaking awesome. I want to change its nature to Jolly. Perfect. All right, so now it's got Jolly Nature, 6 IV. We're gonna make sure that this is correct. 252 attack, 252 speed. We put the other 4 in defense just for giggles. You can look at the attacks that it has and modify those if you want. Max out its power points if you want to. And then you can mess with the trainer data and all this. If you want to, I'm gonna leave mine alone, so I'll leave it the way it is. And yeah, that's pretty much it as far as modifying the Pokemon. Once you are done modifying the Pokemon, you want to left click on the Pokemon that you just modified and hit set, so it officially saves that Pokemon. Otherwise, if you don't do that, then the Pokemon didn't modify it at all. If you want to make additional copies of it, you can also go into empty spots and hit set. And you can make as many copies as you want with it. I personally don't want to do that with Zubat, but I mean, you can do that if you want to with any Pokemon. I pretty much did that with a lot of these other Pokemon. That's how I modified a lot of these here that, you know, I could give away on stream if you guys want. Let me know in the comment section below if you guys want some random giveaways throughout my streams that I do. I'll just like randomly throw in, you know, hey, giving this away, blah, blah, blah. Every Pokemon that I give away through PK Hex will pass the legitimacy check 100% before I give it away. I will not give away a Pokemon that potentially could harm you guys for online play. So keep that in mind. Now, if you want to modify your party, you can literally just go into party and modify it right here. And if you want to modify your save data, like your items, your Pokédex, and all that, you can do that here. Your box layouts, you can modify that. Items, you click on items right here, and you can mess with... So, like, right here, I can give myself, you know, 900 rare candies if I want to. I've already given myself 999 max repels, because eventually I'm on a shiny hunt, and you know you need those max repels, right? Go on down and you can, like, all these spots that say none, you could click on it and say, boom, I want to give myself an ability capsule. You can put ability capsule there, and then you can hit one just to say, hey, I have an ability capsule, or if you want more than one, you know. Now I've got 999 ability capsules. And hit save here. You can do the same thing with your key items. Give yourself a shiny charm, catching charm, secret potion if you want, mess with your bike. TMs and HMs, if you want to give yourself all, and the count will automatically be set to 995, you can literally just hit all, and bam, you have all the TMs and HMs now, if you want to do that with all the items. So you could pretty much do that with here, hit, do the same thing, key items, same thing, your recovery items and potions and all that are right here, berries are right here, Pokeballs are here. I don't know why you'd use any of this, but they're there for you if you want. Your battle items. And then your Grand Underground items. You can modify all that as well if you want. Once you are going through all this, you know, you can go to the Pokédex. Modify this if you want. You can checkmark all to say, I've completed my Pokédex if you really want to go that far with it. Trainer info, you can change your name, you can change your rival's name. Mess with your hours and adventure. And on the underground, you can literally just give yourself items from the underground, so statues and whatnot. You can do all that through here as well. Once you have completed all of that, right? All of that is done, you've done everything that you want to do. You know, go back, we'll check box 2 real fast. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to dupe this just to show you that it is going to work. We'll set an extra Zubat down there just to do it, right? All right, so we're going to go to File. We're going to go to Export Save. We're going to click there where our save data is, and we're going to hit save, and it's going to ask you, save data bin already exists, do you want to replace it? You're going to hit yes, and then it's going to say that it is done. You're going to hit okay. Once all of that is done, you can put your SD card back into your Switch, put your Switch back into CFW mode, and when I do that, I will be right back. All right, once your Switch is back into CFW mode, you're going to hold the R button again, and then you're going to hit A to go back into the game, just to get back into your, checkpoint area. Go back to checkpoint. Make sure you're clicking the one with the flag. I don't know if I said that last time or not. Make sure you're clicking the one with the flag and not the folder itself. So click it, go back to the game that you want to, mess with. And then go down to test and hit A on it, and then it's going to ask you if you want to restore it. You're going to hit yes. Once it's been restored, you can hit the home button and hit the Y button and close out. And then you can actually just go back into the game, and that's all there is to it, guys. Like I said before, though, there is a update that needs to be done with PK Hex. I don't think all the legitimacy is 100% good with it just yet. Most of it is good, but I do know there is some flaws in there. So please, please, please.